viewers, welcome to the analysis of the Europa League draw, which happened this noon. And yeah, unfortunately, what I expected, that the four teams that I have here, at least two of them will play against each other. That happened, and of course it happened that exactly my final is now happening, or in the quarterfinals. We also, as we will see, I think the big winner of the draw is Arsenal in many ways, because we have now the tournament three. And yeah, a Villarreal jersey, and I put on a yellow Arsenal. I don't have a Villarreal jersey, but that looks like something I probably should be looking into getting now, and not disregarding any of the smaller teams that are still in the competition. I would say let's look at how the draw evolved. I mean, the first pairing that was pulled out was Granada against Manchester United. Granada, the lowest rated team is still left in the competition against the highest rated team. So a rather straightforward draw for United, one would think. But you know, Granada, they have been doing well so far. I think they can spring another upset. Then Arsenal got Slavia Praha. Now that is, I think a rather misleading draw. I think Slavia has a good chance against Arsenal. Slavia had no trouble, but you know, they eliminated Leicester, a team that is much better in the Premier League than Arsenal. They now eliminated Rangers, so they're going back to the island, and I can see them causing Arsenal quite some trouble. Slavia is a team not to be underestimated. Of course, when it goes by rating, Arsenal loves this one, absolutely, for sure. And then the one that I didn't want to see, Ajax against Roma. This was my final. I knew it, there was no other big chance, but having this now, yeah. I think that's the best matchup in the quarterfinal. It is definitely the one that is the most evenly matched one. And I'm really curious. Both teams like to play fluid attacking football. I think that Ajax just has a little bit more than Roma at this moment. And that left the last one, Dinamo against Villarreal. Again, one of those. I personally think that Villarreal has shown very well that they can deal with opponents that are, you know, they can spring an upset here and there, but and I consider they're dangerous. They take them serious enough. They did it with Salzburg, they did it with Dinamo Kiev. Now can they do it with Dinamo Zagreb? Let's remain so. I think they're definitely the favorites. And then we have those pairings, but we also got a semifinal and a final draw, which resulted in the following three. We have that the winner of Zagreb against Villarreal plays against the winner of Arsenal against Slavia. Meaning just ratings-wise, this is Villarreal and Arsenal are teams that are not the highest rated ones. I mean, Arsenal, I think, was number two, and Villarreal, as far as I remember, was number five in the rating. We'll see this in just a bit again. And then we have the lower one we have with Ajax and Roma already for 3 and 5 meeting, and the man mentioned in one. So the lower part looks a little bit more loaded than the higher part, which not discounting Slavia and Dinamo, it really is nicely poised for Villarreal Arsenal semifinal, and that would be an interesting one just because of Unai Emery. And now we can actually assess how the draw impacted the team's chances, because these are the chances that we had right before the draw that I posted earlier today. I mean, this posted on Saturday, so that I posted yesterday. And we can see here it's really nicely by the strength of the teams. We have United, Arsenal, Ajax, Villarreal, Roma, Slavia, Dinamo and Granada in that order. And now, after the draw, boom, Arsenal gets a boost, Villarreal get a boost because they get drawn against the number 6 and 7 teams. Whereas United and Ajax take a hit, and United actually takes quite the hit. You see it also in the chance. I mean, United will reached the final in about 50% of the time in the simulation. However, they will always play a tough opponent. Whereas if Arsenal and Villarreal go in there, yes, they might play against United, where the outsiders, but they also might play some other opponents, and their route to the final, in a way, is also, you know, pretty much on par. They are very likely to both end up in the semifinals. So I'm wearing Arsenal. Arsenal is the big winner of the draw, as is Villarreal. So I think that's the takeaway from that. I also find it curious that Roma remains entirely unchanged. But, you know, if you're in the number five spot, you were bound to get a difficult team. We also have the dates for the matches. Well, they also didn't come really a surprise, because everything is played at 9 on the 8th and on the 15th of April. So they're played within a week of each other, which actually means for me getting the Villarreal jersey. Either I wait for the result of this one, or I have to go quickly about it. In any case, it's pretty clear. Ajax Roma, that's the one that I'm looking forward the most. So yeah, what are your thoughts on the draw? Do you agree with my probabilities? Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more. And I will talk to you soon. Bye. If you enjoyed this video, and if you did, here are some videos and playlists that you might enjoy too. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel and hit the little bell icon to get updated whenever something happens in my soccer universe. And with that, have a wonderful day. Bye.